Please take your seat, sir. Please take your seat, yeah. So after the two presentations now, we have a third round of panel discussion on retail therapy. One of the salient features of the Tamil market is its retail clientele with a regional advertising revenue potential to the tune of rupees 500 crore. Retail and hyperlocal advertising is expected to gain more steam in the next 5 years. So will local brands divert their spends to TV, or will they move away from using single media to multimedia strategy? To answer these questions and more, I would like to invite Mr. Chaitanya Gurijala, Head of Marketing and Media, SRM University. With 15 years of experience in media, from agency to client, expertise in TV, media plan, digital and marketing and branding. So next, I would like to invite Dr. R Sakthivel, Founder and Chief Executive Officer, Challenge Advertising. So he is a visionary entrepreneur who runs the highly successful Challenge Advertising and Global Media Connection. His ability to think out of the box, both in terms of marketing strategy and advertising campaigns, have helped his clients achieve massive growth. And next, I would like to invite Mr. BS Vishal, Vice President Marketing of Viveks. Mr. Vishal is a retail specialist in the industry of consumer durables and IT for over 8 years. Can we give a huge round of applause? Currently, he is handling the buying and sales of LED TVs, smartphones, laptops and digital products. So next, let's give a big round of applause and welcome Mr. Viswanathan Devraj, Business Head, Jaya TV Network. He has more than 18 years of experience. Are you all feeling sleepy? Can we give a huge round of applause, please? So he has more than 18 years of experience in various capacities of sales, marketing and business development. And the session will be moderated by Mr. RBU Shyam Kumar, Executive Director, WinNews and Founder, President, Cornerstone, former CEO of Puthiya Thalaimurai Group. So let's give a huge round of applause and welcome Mr. Shyam. So he has around 31 years of experience ranging from direct marketing to media broadcasting. So he's been a launchman and a game changer right through his career. So let's move on to the panel discussion. Thank you.
Thank you. And a very good evening to one and all. It's a pleasure to be here on this session, Retail Therapy. I'd like to first congratulate the organizing team for forming this word, Retail Therapy. I was trying to find out the meaning of therapy, and Tesra said, putting it in order. And I was trying to find out what is disorder. But ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure that happy days are here again. The advertising industry has started seeing growth since 2018 again, after the slump in 2016 and 17. And 2018 first saw the growth, and then 2019 it is estimated to 9,980 crore, which means close to 10,000 crore increase, taking the ADEX to 70,000 crore, and of which 16% of the GDP is going to be driven by the retail sector, which is close to around 30,000 crore, which is a huge, and of which again, Tamil Nadu has always been unique in advertising too. So, as they have seated, I'd like to start with Mr. Sakthivel, a visionary. Last time when I saw him some 15, 16 years back, he was trying to sell us an outdoor medium. But today I'm so glad to see him on the dais, an inspiring leader, taking challenge advertising across the globe. And how is this Tamil Nadu retail industry unique to something similar to other symptoms that we see in Tamil Nadu industry?
A very good evening. Thank you, Shyam sir, for giving such a nice introduction. Yes, as you said rightly, advertising industry, Tamil Nadu advertising industry, media and advertising, has its own uniqueness. I would like to give a small comparison. This media and advertising industry in Tamil Nadu can be compared to the mindset of the public when Tamil Nadu people look into politics also. When the recent parliament election, when the entire country was towards one particular wave, you can see the state party has won a majority. Almost for half a century, the state parties are ruling the state and not the national party. Even in parliament election also, only the state party performs. So likewise, most of the brands here, even Mr. Ramesh from Kalimark is sitting here, and Mr. Chaitanya from SRM Group. When it comes to advertising, they always prefer a regional agency to give them a service rather than a larger agency or a national agency. So I would like to compare that.
Fantastic. I remember, again, another gentleman who was in the media planning business, but then today he's sitting here in the panel as a marketing head of one of the biggest advertisers in the education segment. This is another unique thing which is happening in Tamil Nadu, especially when nationally there are four sectors which are driving the television index, especially FMCG, auto, telecom, and education. And of which education in Tamil Nadu, we have very limited players and very renowned players. Why is that you are taking print into consideration more, leaving the television industry with only 1% of the of your entire budgeting?
Thank you very much, Shyam. And thank you, the organizers, for inviting me. Frankly speaking, I am a great television fan. I started my career with the television planning as an expert in television planning. But when I moved from agency to client, and especially education as a medium, it is always said, done that education, the more silent and more indirect you are, the more better brand it has been. I have a different views as a marketing head. I've been fighting with my management every quarter, but successfully failed for last 10 years with the brand. But yes, if you see education industry was supposed to spend, the spends have not grown in last 4 years as compared to what it used to be 4 years back. Because of so many reasons, because of education policies and because of what the diversification of the new IITs and NITs that came into picture. With all this happening, print definitely was a big thumbs up for so many reasons. You should also understand, you come from print background, you understand. Today you are on the other side. But print will give that edge to education institutes to still survive and get that belief that parents are looking out for an education institute to be more subtle. Subtle is always a great mantra which some of the world's best universities across the globe, which still used it to build the brands. That's the only reason why I'm still finding it. But yes, there are a few universities which has termed in a different manner, abroad in North India especially. They went Ganga about all television channels, especially in sports, especially in music channels and news channels. And they create a quick buzz and then made a huge revenue. I can name their universities like Amity, universities like Lovely Professional University used television as a medium. I still believe that if you want a sudden spike and if you still want a greater visibility and you wanted to reach most of the audience in the country, television is still a better medium to get into that.
Yes, Chaitanya, we understand that. Coming from a print medium and now in the television industry, if there is something on written page, people take that as a document. Yep. So when there is a ranking, when there is a particular announcement made, a print always carries that extra mileage. I'll come to you a little later after the first round on what do you expect in a television industry, if you want that kind of revolution, Now, moving on to the next panelist, if I may think of rebranding, revamping, the inspiration that I can draw from are, there are a couple of brands. One is A2B, and two is definitely Bovento. It's just that it is coming as I think. So we saw a wonderful presentation of yours, an inspiring journey. Now, how was this possible of revamping Bovento, and what was the medium did you take? How did you do this? What is the case study that you would like to share to the audience in this entire journey of yours, especially on the Bovento success story?
Thank you, Mr. Shyam.
Hello. Thank you, Mr. Shyam. Actually, I'm very proud to share some of our journey from 1916, some incidents. Actually, we have been using only, in the initial stage, we have been using only wall paintings. So at the time, during the year 1925, if you go to south, you can very well see that all the houses, we will be having our advertisement in Kalimark. So, as you've seen in the media, our brand Bovento was introduced in the year 1959. So, I'm very proud to say that the media, particularly TVs, helped us very lot to be in a very better position in Tamil Nadu. So you know very well, so Tamil Nadu people are very sensitive. They believe what they see. So we are, normally we will be putting our all the advertisement in their minds. Giving all the, what are the medias available? Wall painting, papers, TVs. So the, we normally, 75% budget, we are allocating only for TVs. So particularly for Bovento, we are promoting as a unique brand. So, to the election, TV played a very vital role in our brand. Thank you.
Very true. Mr. Satish asked me a simple question. Do you drink Bovento, or does your family have Bovento? I see very often a Bovento bottle kept inside a refrigerator than a Coke or a Pepsi. A family doesn't advocate or advise somebody to have the other drinks, but Bovento, they are not, it has become a family drink. And moving on to the next panelist, if I may recollect my days when I started as a door-to-door salesman of Eureka Forbes in 30 years back, I remember the first people who introduced New Year's sale in Tamil Nadu, like how Mr. Shakti said, there's so many things unique to Tamil Nadu, like the RD sale that we are doing, the retail revolution. Oh, gone are those days when we don't buy, but now we are rushing. Everybody says about RD sale. That's a retail disorder therapy that we have given. So, an order in disorder, rather. Viveks has been unique in New Year sailing, in higher purchase scheme, and a renowned retail giant, if I may say so. What was the success, and how did you do your branding and the advertising part of it?
We started in the year 1965. So back then, the competition was very, very less, probably only 2-3 players in the entire industry. Everything started that time was only print. And I would say word of mouth was a very, very strong medium then. I would say till date, we are known by trust. And that has sort of given us a good foothold. So, and our industry again is led by offers. So TVC as such is only of a brand recall. So if you see even our budgets as such, it's probably very, very little compared to print. Print is probably, I would say, close to 80-85% we spend on print compared to TVC. But there are, today things are changing. We see that, okay, there are national players like Reliance, Chroma. There are probably even regional players like your Satya, Vasant. They all have spread across Tamil Nadu as such. For them, I see TVC probably gives more leverage than people like us. So we, our foothold or footprint is comparatively less than Satya or the Vasants or the RR, MR partners. So that way, for us, still we believe that print actually gives us a lot more value than TVC.
Yes, we always see the moment, gone are those days when the news consumption was waited for the morning newspaper to arrive and all that. Like what we saw in the earlier presentation, the news consumption pattern has changed now. And so people have started buying newspaper for the offers and for the kind of advertisements. And FMCG and the consumer durables are taking, rather consumer durables take that route very strongly. Even though the market is growing only by 5% in the print industry, but education and the consumer durable industry are sticking on to it. We'll come to you because we as broadcaster now are also keen. How do we attract the segments like education and consumer durable? The reason why I'm in asking that is the next panelist is from the broadcasting side. So we have with us Viswanath from Jaya TV. The huge challenge, Viswanath, on attracting the retail advertisers. What is the strategy? How are you going? What is the extra mile that television channels are taking today to attract the retailers especially? Because Tamil Nadu has got 300 crore advertisement in the retail advertisement industry is close to 300 crore approximately, of which how are you planning as a broadcaster to attract this?
Thank you, Shyam. Before answering this question, I would like to, where is Sana? Somewhere here. She has brought up a wonderful set of panels. Okay, there are two guys who says we have never been on to TV, will not be on TV. Okay, thank you, Chaitanya. Thank you, Vishal. And there are two people who are here to support TV primarily. They say that, you know, 85% of my budget is on TV, right? So this is what exactly we are facing.
And two of the broadcasters out here, yes, are trying to pitch in. Already they have started collecting all their visiting cards and trying to pitch in around.
Already meetings have been fixed. Right. Thank you. I'll come to this particular question. You know, Jaya TV is a giant. There's no two questions about that. You know, this come August 22nd, we celebrate our 21st anniversary. And Tamil Nadu is a market or is a beast which we couldn't even find out what exactly where is. Okay, even after all these years, you know, we are still struggling to find out, you know, what's the pulse of the market. There's no one in this industry who can say that, you know, I can gauge the pulse or I can get into the exact details of war, what, how, where the movement is going to be. As somebody said, you know, there is one factor which is trust, right? Trust is what makes Kalimark to move or even Viveks to move. Here, we are planning to get into this 300 crore retail market by banking on digital. Now, the movement has gone to a level whereby you have to have a very strong digital team to promote your own television industry. That's the situation that has come now. Digital is eating up our market. Slowly by steadily, there is this FICCI report which says that, you know, currently it's 21% of the market share of the advertising industry goes to digital. And it's supposed to be like 25% in the next 3 years and all. I'll if the time is there, you know, for this introduction session, I'll share one small anecdote. There is this guy called Savarit Semia. Okay, he sits somewhere in Dindigul. Dindigul is like, you know, after Madurai and all, you people might have known about this thing and all, you know. Savarit Semia, we went for a presentation and all, you know, and that guy... You know why I went for a presentation with Savarit Semia? I was watching Sony Live NBA matches in the morning and Savarit Semia's advertisement comes in this app. Savarit Semia, a guy who sits in Dindigul, his advertisements are there in Sony Live and he is a very strong believer of OTT platform. That's the kind of idea and the forward thinking these retail market people have started to have. Don't ever think the digital or the retailers over here as somebody who's, you know, the Annachis who can very easily go and make a presentation and get your money and all. No, gone are the days. The word retail, the very word retail itself is a 14th century word, Anglo-Norman word or from old French, which says, you know, to take a piece off, right? That is what we media people or salespeople used to do in the previous days and all. We just go there, make a small, make a wonderful, sassy presentation and then get the money. No, it's not like that. They can give you gyan, like the guy who gave me a gyan in Savrit Semia. So as a channel person, as a business head, you know, my idea is to get the money by making a presentation through digital. And we would love to have a combination of digital. As Srinivasan said earlier in the day, you know, from Ananda Vigatan was making his presentation, his combo is like print, digital, and TV. That's the same combination.
Absolutely. Moving from a television medium to a digital medium, and the generation, gone are those days when we had generation of 20 years. Now it is Gen X, 4 years. That's the kind of speed with which the treadmill is moving. And if we are not moving, then we will have to fall. So if we are moving in that pace, Mr. Sakthivel, there is this movement which we have seen across. There is this outdoor industry which was predominantly taken by real estate, retails, announcements, making. And since you were a part of outdoor industry initially, and then moving in and seeing this part, how do you see, where is the movement going towards now? Where is this entire retail or advertising movement, especially with regard to retail or the real estate or the BFCI advertising moving into now?
Right from morning, we have been discussing about television being the dominating media. Right from morning, we are discussing about that. Even now, as a retail, a regional advertising agency handling a lot of retail brands, I believe Tamil Nadu is still a television market. And I would like to add some points to Mr. Saithanya's statement. Even though his own management is not giving importance to television, they stick on more towards print, but he himself admitted a lot of other education institutions have made use of television.
I tried a lot when I was the CEO of Puthiya Thalaimurai, which is a part of SRM University, to get some advertisements from Chaitanya, but I couldn't. Anyway.
But I can give you a small example where some 18 years back, because challenge advertising was started in 2000 and CSE Computer Education came on board as a very first client. I used to see his advertisement being given in a classified session of Hindu, where an 8x5 size advertisement telling, we are giving you 75% scholarship. If you are ready to appear for the aptitude test, then you are eligible for 75% scholarship. Then one fine day, what I did is I went and met the MD of CSE Computer Education. I told, sir, your TG is somewhere between 15 years to 20 years. So, so when you have an opportunity to advertise in television to reach your exact TG, then why you are not there? Why you are still spending money in print alone? Then he told me, I don't have bigger budgets to come on television. I told, what is your budget? He told somewhere on 4 to 5 lakh rupees for a month campaign. One complete month, you'll be spending only 5 lakhs. I told, it's very well possible with this 5 lakh budget to go on television. And I did a film for 50,000 rupees with the television celebrity in those days. And I ran a campaign in 3 different channels, in GEC channels, the programs targeting that particular age group. And he saw the response from television. And after that, within a span of 3 to 4 years, from a 10-center computer institute, they grow up to 350 centers. And they were doing almost 150 crore annual billing. And only 10% of his net profit was spent towards advertising. So that is what a regional agency like us can understand, the pulse of the audience. We can understand the brand and give them a right solution. So I think still television will be there. Yes, I agree, digital is taking up. It can be a television and a digital mix, but it can't be digital alone. They have to bet on television.
I don't want to come on a same cycle. I want to cut through Chaitanya and move to Sir, the Kalimark brand, Ramesh Sir. We've seen especially the beverages industry and the lifestyle industry make use of actors as their brand ambassador. Whereas you have taken a separate route by, if I'm right, Muthaiya Muralidharan is your brand ambassador.
Yeah.
Is there any logic behind that? And we'd like to learn from your approach on that, if that be the case of your revamp.
Yes, of course.
So, on a lighter note, Muthaiya Muralidharan got married in Tamil Nadu, maybe that's the reason.
Actually, he's only Tamilian, sir, actually. He's coming from nearby Mannargudi.
Yeah.
He's not actually a Sri Lankan.
Okay.
So, his birthplace is near Mannargudi only. But however, we are having our own policy that we will never engage celebrities for our advertisement. However, to adapt with the recent trends, right now we have engaged two celebrities, like Aksara Ghazan as one of our brand ambassador, Nikki Galrani. So, we have to adopt some recent trends so that we have changed our policy. We have to make some adjustments.
So, you are getting into a therapy mode, getting into the actors also as brand ambassador.
Yes. No. We will go for actors.
Okay. That's a good news for you, Sakthi. So, there's another thing which I wanted to ask, if I may, Sakthivel, sir, is that we have in this retail industry, Tamil Nadu especially, we have the brand owners coming as brand ambassadors. You call it the legend to everybody. They are the brand ambassadors. I'm talking about the brand ambassador. Well, how do you think that? I think one of the biggest, the oldest inspiration was Vasanthan Ko, sir. And from there, it all started. But what do you think about this uniqueness in retail advertising as such? And coming on the visual media.
The market has accepted that. Absolutely. I think everyone has accepted those brand ambassadors. It is even more authentic for them, the owners themselves. Even I could like to say Mr. Ramesh of Pothis. He came as a brand ambassador along with Kamala Ghazan.
Yes.
And it did some influence in
for
the market.
For goodwill.
Received well.
Fantastic. Now, moving on to you, Chaitanya, I'm not going to leave you until you start spending in television medium. So
please.
Now there is somebody else competing along with me. What is your thought process, especially your TG is the student segment. And the student segment seem to be moving at a faster pace with the digital world. What do you think that educational segment as such has to move in, and what do you think is going to be the next strategy? Because you're all going through a huge challenge now in terms of education policy, in terms of all the moves that is happening across, be it political, be it in the other scenario also, reforms.
I would like to tell you, even though I don't advertise on television, the kind of strategies that we built in last 10 years, you will appreciate why without television we are still able to create, I'll say, the craze among the plus two students. If at all they are not getting into IITs and IITs, they have to join good private universities like SRM University. See, we know that student psyche today is entirely, and their lingo is entirely different from what you and I were studying. If you see, even though I don't have a brand ambassador, in last 10 years, I got more than 100 film stars coming to my campus. But it is subtle. Even though I don't advertise on television, the kind of musical shows I have done across the country, not only country, globe, we get almost all students from 54 countries, and our 80% student is from different states. So in some way down the line, it is a so subtle advertising that we spent and tried to got into the mind space of students with the kind of activities, the kind of education, the kind of yo thing that a student is looking at. And you know that students this day doesn't look just only the building or a campus, they also look at peers. It is always, education is always like how Viveks was telling, that it is a word of mouth that catches up, and then it has been surviving for so many years despite they are not on television. Especially education, that what boils down finality is the word of mouth and the kind of campus placements and the kind of good students that the chain keeps happening. I think indirectly, somewhere down the line, if I say television is equal to entertainment, and entertainment some way down the line, all the brands has to be part of it, because that's where the easiness of the mind is. That's where easy to escape into the mind. That's the reason why we still survive without not doing on television. But yeah, I think it's been too late where digital has catched up so much. For example, there is a branded content that we are doing in one of my campus where Amitabh Bachchan, John Abraham and few other people are in talks with us to have a one-day shoot in the campus. See, the content piece and the digital piece has taken so much into the brand that if you are smart enough, especially on education space, I will not comment on the other retail space, because retail space has a much wider audience and wider minds to get into it. So digital has already caught into it. In last 10 years, my digital spends have grown from when I joined in 2009, the desk spends was 50,000 rupees. Now I'm spending 12 crores on digital. And SRM is one of the largest spender on education space, on digital space. So, which is almost all eaten away 20% of print budget. And so you can imagine what print digital is actually catching up to.
So digital is eating the print budget. That's why digital is projected to grow at 33% in the year 2019, yep, to 15,000 crore in the ADEX. And coming to that, sticking on to this digital, though it is tele-wise, tele is something a long distance. And now we have to look at long distance vision. Now, that's the wisdom I'm sure IndianTelevision.com wanted to have, a long vision. Viveks, now your competition is now no more has, I mean, the competition space, we feel, has changed from your next door competition. There were, at one point of time, I still remember when I was with BPL in 95, there were so much of dealer networks. Every street you will have a small television shop and you will have a small dealer network. And all that is come down to a big showroom. Indianization of the retailing had happened. But now your competition has again moved to e-com, where people have started viewing it here and buying it through e-commerce. And how are you, the Amazons and the Flipkarts and whatever you name it, everybody is there. So what is your strategy going to be in this, especially in terms of specifically to advertising and your market approach on that?
The Flipkart, the Amazons are going to continue to be there, and their penetration is going to increase year on year. They are going to eat into our share. And there's nothing that we can do about it as long as they are funded enough. But if you see in terms of retail, especially our industry, everyone is expanding. I would say probably all over the country, Tamil Nadu has probably close to about 700 to 800 retail stores, be it the specialty stores or the general consumer durables like us. So again, I would say for us in Tamil Nadu, I would say probably for the next 5 to 7 years, people will still walk into our stores, buy, touch, feel, and then walk out. Yes, today Amazon Flipkart is probably a tool to negotiate. It is probably the millennials who want to shop, or it's more of a convenience. And the day Amazon or Flipkart gets back to their price list, I'm sure none of them are going to buy. Today, if you come and do a hard buy from us, we will also be able to match. People are not aware of that. They expect that at one go, we give away the price. That's not the case. We cannot. We are governed by Sony, Samsung, LG. They are not governed by Sony, Samsung, LG.
Okay, now moving on to you. There we have seen close to around 10 channels mushrooming in the last 4-5 years. And there's a huge fight, competition, battle for the market share that is there. How are you planning to attract this retail segment as a broadcaster? And what is your strategy beyond? There is something else which is again unique to television industry, especially regional channels. is the experiential marketing which is happening, the events. People are going, Fiki had reported close to around 800 events conducted by the regional channels especially. So what is your approach going to be to attract the retail segment and to build the base as such?
Thank you. In your question itself, you know, you gave me a hint for the answer. Events, to reach out people. Jaya TV was revamped last year in October 14. And ever since then, you know, we've been trying to reach out people saying that, you know, the brand is back, the giant is woken up and everything is going to be normal again. After all these political situations, which I don't want to talk about, however Chaitanya might want me to pull into, I will not. Okay. The thing is that, you know, we've been trying to reach out people through events. We've been doing events across Tamil Nadu in all major places. For example, we started last year, December, with an event in Coimbatore, an SPB musical show where 12,000 people thronged in for all the ticketed things. Ever since that, you know, we've been trying to experiment with the SEC markets, where for one particular place, the same thing might not be working in the next market. For example, an event that we've been planned and scheduled and been experimented in one market, say, for example, in Coimbatore, might not be have the same effect in, say, Tirunelveli or in Madurai and all. So for each market, you know, we've studied and we've been doing monthly events in each and every one of those places. The idea is to make sure that, you know, as, you know, he was talking about the touch feel effect and all, you know, people in Tamil Nadu still has a tendency, I don't know for how many years this is going to be, he said about 7 years and all, touch wood, it should remain. See, the Tamil Nadu people, you know, still they wanted to see something in front of their eyes, then only they will believe and all. What happens is that, you know, for so long, our network hasn't been trying to reach out people. You just stayed in our own HQ and we've done nothing to reach out to the people and all. So what we have been doing for the last 1 year is that, you know, to reach out people. We've been shouting at people saying that, you know, we are back, we are doing these events and all. Through those events, I'm promoting all my new shows and contents that we've been catering. For example, in the last 1 year, we started 7 new shows and 2-3 reality game shows, stuff like that and all, you know. For that, I'm using events in every major town in Tamil Nadu to reach out. And through those events, I'm promoting my own programs and new content that I've been developing. Of course, I used same thing. I used to advertise TV. When I did revamp, you know, I've gone through all these channels. You know, I've taken about 100 outdoor units. I've done print. I've done radio. I've done TV. And still, I went for digital also. At the end of the day, however giant might be a channel, like a 20-year-old channel might be, but if you want to reach out to people, you have to go through 360 degree of advertisements, which what we did last year for about 3 to 4 months continuously. There is an idea which says that, you know, that, you know, if you want to reach out people, the millennials especially, you have to go through only digital. That's the only way. There's no other way. Okay, so what we have done is that, you know, recently we have revamped a new team for digital and all. Suddenly you might be seeing that, you know, there will be so many content which will be popping up in your social media from our content team and all.
True. Now, every broadcaster, every company, every brand has started a content factory inside as their back-end office. They are doing, there's no more time for wait or a brief for a agency which we used to call and then give and all that is not happening now. Immediately, you have to get into disruptive marketing. I can't leave this, Mr. Sakthivel. I was wondering whether I should take this up or not. But the last presentation Nair had given provoked me and prompted me that I should ask this question. Another uniqueness to Tamil industry, be it we call it retail or anything, is film advertising and cinema advertising, where you have made a breakthrough and you've created a real pathway there. Cinema industry is set to grow 1,000 crore in 2019. That's the projection that we have received. Now, in this, how big is this industry? How can a retail brand play into it, can come into it as an in-show branding or whatever it is? And what is your advice to the panel as well as to us as the audience? Because you have already started this path-breaking move into the film advertising.
Yes.
How much is the kind of advertising that we are getting as broadcasters for every week or kind of yearly?
Yes. Challenge advertising, of course, I should say, we have identified a lot of untrapped verticals and brought into television, right from education. We brought education into television. When they were very strongly depending on print, we did ad films and we promoted them in music channels, news channels, and later branding movies, all those stuff. Real estate for that matter, whenever a new project is launched, a power jacket, a full 4-page pullout will be there. But later we converted them into television, and now top 7-8 brands are very active in television. Similarly, cinema. We took cinema some 15-16 years back itself, when movies like Autograph and all got in, released. Initially what happened, this 1 minute or 2 minute trailers, which is being aired free of cost as a filler for the television channel. On a non-prime time slot, channels used to put these trailers as a filler. But we met few producers and we explained them, why should not you put a 10-seconder or a 20-seconder, a TVC kind of a thing, to promote your movie, on which date this movie is getting released, something about the subject, all those stuff. After quite a good number of movies were very successful after promoting on television, now out of 100 movies, almost 95 movies are promoted on television and radio, and Challenge handles most of these promotions. Even this Thalai Ajit movie, which is getting released day after tomorrow, Neer Kondai Parvai, is promoted by Challenge Advertising. And last week, another movie got released, Jyotika's Jackpot. It was promoted by Challenge. So coming to the point that in-film advertising to take the brands inside movie, I don't think it's, even now, it's not well-organized sector.
That's okay. The therapy that we are looking at. Now, okay. That's the order that we thought. There is a huge opportunity for either in-film advertising or in-show advertising for the brands that is there, because the retail brands have grown so rapidly, including the reality shows and things like that. Are they open to it, and what is your...
No, actually producers are approaching us, even the directors, they normally come and present us with the options of taking an in-film branding, all those stuff. But the thing is, yes, to a certain extent, Hindi, they are doing it in a very proper way. Hindi films, they are doing it a proper way. But Tamil, we have tried quite some projects, and some were very successful and some have been very... a very disastrous experience, actually. So I think before we get into that in a big way, some proper systematic methodology should be applied.
What is the kind of advertising revenue from a film, just by film advertisement, that a broadcaster or a television industry can gain? What is the estimate?
No, I think Vishwa is here to acknowledge my statement that is... almost, I think, 20% of the revenue comes from movie vertical. 20%. Because even this
That's
movie, the spend was almost 1.75 crore for a two-week campaign.
Isn't it 2.25 crore, sir?
1.75 crore.
Okay.
1.75 crore.
I'll check my resources.
Two-week campaign.
Which was trying
and almost to 40 to 50 movies in a year, they spend that sort of money.
And you know, before we get into this thing, you know, Mr. Sakthivel is also an executive producer. He produced a film way back in 2007-8. Okay, and there is this film Subramanyapuram. I don't know how many of you recall, which was a path-breaking film. And he played a very vital role in that film getting into a big level.
Multifaceted, Mr. Sakthivel. And to you, Chaitanya, with a fall in... the education segment, especially the engineering application forms, I mean, the engineering admissions falling down drastically across. What do you think as an educational brand that you will advertise or you will advise the other educational brands to do, especially when there is so much of the shift happening from engineering to back to arts and science and things like that? How do you see the future and where are we heading for this?
It's a huge case study. I'm sure I'll try to sum up as soon as possible. See, the trends in last 10 years in engineering has changed drastically. 10 years down the line or 5 years down the line, there was no AI, machine learning and IoT and all this stuff. So now every student who is aspiring engineer wants to study only AI or machine learning. I only know when application starts and registration starts. Out of 100 students, 99 wants AI. On the first day on counseling, within an hour, people are willing to pay whatever price to get into AI, to get study, because that is has been projected as the next the thing. One side, the IT is not able to produce great enough jobs, but despite that, AI, machine learning, and IoT will still thrive the next gen students to be the greater engineers that they are supposed to be. Then the other courses which supposed to pick up civil, mechanical, which is not doing that great because of the job opportunities are definitely not there. With this, arts and science has become an alternative for people to get into civil services, gets more time for them, gets into a law. Law has picked up tremendously great. With that, liberal arts has become the next, the in thing, because the so-called big companies are paying the not so-called engineers as the great thing. They're thinking the people who can manage people are the one who has to be paid more. That is what you get learnt in liberal arts. This is what we all does and get least paid here. With the next 10 years down the line, that means by the time we talk in 2028, most of the jobs that are there in engineering space may not be there in whatever this, because the infrastructure, the IT, the everything is changing so fast. So education is going in under major transformation. Universities like us have greater steps to introduce so many new courses. Media is booming, and media industry and advertising industry is set to be grow.
As a marketing head, how are you planning to take this across to the TG?
No, it's very simple strategy that we follow. We need parents and we need students. And we have bucketed those parents in three segments. The parents who can afford to pay a premium, the parents who are afford to pay the normal fees and able to get into this private universities, and this aspiring parents. We bucket these three into three different areas, and we then bucketed them into different mediums. A parent who is an SCCA would want to see my ad in Economic Times. If a parent who is in SCCC would definitely want his peer who is bigger than him to come and say that SRM is a good college. Okay, so it's a wider range of bucketing that we do and do multiple things. That's the reason why when I release a print ad, I give ad to all the print people.
So segmenting and segmentation marketing is...
You have to be very keen on that.
Sir Ramesh, sir, Bhavanto is... your flagship, 95% of your business comes from Bhavanto. Now, what are your plans in terms of Bhavanto expansion? Because as we are moving into a fast-paced world and beverages, and food and beverages is another big advertiser in the AdX report. So how are you planning to expand your expansion plans? And what is your marketing plans and brand building plans on that?
So,
especially you have seven factories, if I'm right.
Yes,
and your logistics is going to be a huge challenge here. And fighting the big wigs again. And how is your national footprint? Can you throw us some light on that?
Of course. Right now, as you said, Bhavanto is our unique brand. So in upcoming months, we are going to launch with low sugar. First of all, there may be a chance we may be Bhavanto Plus or Bhavanto Light. We are planning for that. However, our R&D has already finished. We have finished. In the meantime, we are having some other issues in GST. However, we have already filed some petitions before the council, which will be shortlisted very soon. We have entered into some agreements with our Calcutta units as well as Assam, Guwahati, some other north states. We are going to introduce our entire range of products. So that's our next plan. We would like to bring our products into pan-India.
The next thing we are planning for some global. It will take minimum 18 to 24 months to have our entire brand of products into global. So this is our upcoming plans. In the meantime, you are asking for the logistics. We are having two types of issues. One is primary logistics from factory to our depots. Right now, we are operating around 9 depots in Tamil Nadu and 3 depots in other states. So all the products are being carried away from Tamil Nadu, from Dindigul to our neighboring depots. So that's our primary logistics. And from depo to distributors, secondary logistics. So we have to use various carriers. Like for primary, we have to use lorries. For secondary markets, we have to use some Tata A's.
You have an excellent vehicle branding which can be done. That's what I was trying to
say. One seat next to you.
Of course.
Both sides.
So this is our logistics are major headache. However, we are having separate department to handle all those things. So far, we are having around 9 to 10 contractors. So normally, we will be freezing all of our ratings, including TV budgets and whatever it is, we will be freezing 1 year ahead. So we will have no confusions in any of our budgets. We will have never confusion for allocating logistics, so appointing new contractor, whatever it is. So everything will be done 1 year ahead.
Sir, if I may add a point.
Bovento, you know, I've been following, I'm not that much old, but I've been following through history and second-hand resources and stuff like that. In 1986, when the print was still the number one medium and radio was upcoming and all, you know, Bovento or Kalimark in those days and all, you know, they went into a media vehicle. They used an artist called Gopulu, the legendary late artist Gopulu from Tamil Nadu and all. He hand-drew certain images like an elephant which comes to a shop and gets an Bovento from the shop owner and all. There were about three different creatives which were drawn by Gopulu, and it came in all the leading magazines in those days like Ananda Vigadan, Kalki, Kumudam, every one of those magazines and all. You know, that changed the way people looked into those advertisements in the print medium in those days. Likewise, I believe Bovento will have, with sir being there in the helm and all, they will have a systematic plan or a strategy to tap into, because those advertisements in 1984, 85, 86 has made a huge change, because everyone was going for either a model or a photo advertisements, but they changed the game by putting up hand-drawn cartoon advertisements. Likewise, hopefully they will have an idea strategy.
Yes, of course. Vishal, now we see, once upon a time we saw those BPL galleries, and then we see Sony exclusive showrooms and things like that. But how do you manage to increase the footfall for your multi-brand showrooms like yours? And what is the branding or the advertising strategy, the medium that you use in bringing the footfall, increasing the footfall, even though when we have exclusive showrooms?
To answer to your first question in terms of the brand shops, they are declining. Brands are not retail specialists. They do not have the wing or the capacity or the capability. And today, I would say brands are sort of struggling online and offline. So when it comes to these multi-brand outlets like us, we sort of have to, one, expand, two, start creating stickiness.
Stickiness.
Yeah, so somehow retain our existing customers and acquire new customers. So in terms of stickiness, there are several factors that go into it and several methods that we can do it over a period of time. Let's take, for example, there's another brand called Vijay Sales in the North, who's pretty famous, and he's considered like an MR. So we found out his statistics, though he's also close to about 50-year-old brand. He says till date, I have not acquired new customers. I have gained customers, my own customers, in those respective pockets. He says the millennials are not coming to him. Though he has gadgets which are available online as well. So he has his challenges, we have our challenges. So today we are probably fighting, saying how we can gain these millennials or the young customers of tomorrow. They are probably actually the decision makers, or will be the decision makers in the forthcoming years. So this is where we stand.
Mr. Sakthivel, even though radio is not as robustly growing as television or digital in the adex reports that we see, but retails take a lot of interest in radio. Is there any particular part in that, why they prefer radio also, even now in terms of this advertising as a vehicle, as a medium?
A few verticals, they won't prefer radio, but retail is one vertical where they want to be present in every other medium, right from television to print to radio. And of course, morning drive time or evening drive time is their main catchment area, I think. So they can't avoid radio.
Excellent. So another question which I'd like to ask our friend is from Jaya TV. It's subtitling. How do you see subtitling working? Because in a movie, people stick on when there is subtitling. But in a reality show or in any other, especially the serials, and any other stickiness product or the program that we are talking about, why don't we as broadcasters look at subtitling as an option which will draw more brands into our fold?
I agree to the point that, you know, the stickiness increases or the viewership increases when there is a subtitle part. I'll give an example. In Singapore or MediaCorp, where they have this Vasantham and other stuff and all, you know, if there is a Tamil movie which is playing on, they put subtitle in four different languages. Even for Tamil movie, there will be subtitle in Tamil itself, right? It's really hard to digest, but that's a fact. Okay, likewise here, for example, Vijay TV, which goes on in Singapore, has all their programs subtitled in all those four languages and all. But it's a very costly affair.
But where moving hyperlocal and moving into this particular segment, I'm sure it will draw a lot of brands. Because
true,
coming from a new segment, I see, if even if there is four or five Aston bands and scrolls running across, if there is one small mistake there, immediately they say that it is that there is so much of stickiness in those Aston bands and the scrolls. So why can't GEC segment try subtitling as one of the options and break the rule and get more traction or the stickiness, so that we can have more retail advertisers? Forget about the advertisers. The first thing is we are building a new base.
True. See, there was this experiment done by Amazon, where whenever there is some event happens and all, you know, they try to get in live subtitling happening also. There is this theory. I'll suggest AWS, the website, there is it is. However, here, as I said, you know, it's a quite costly affair for us. In particularly in South India, it's a quite costly affair. A giant like Crickinfo, ESPN Crickinfo, they themselves stopped putting, they started using more and more video content over there in their website than into the printed interview stuff like over there and all. So when there is an interview happens and you put all those scripts in there, that itself is quite costly. That's what Badri Sheshadri told me when I was having this interaction with him and all. Later on here in GEC particularly, it will be increasing the stickiness, but it will be in quite costly an affair. It will take some time. But it will be definitely a very good addition to the viewers. Yes.
It costs about 12,000 per half hour.
A little bit more than...
Anil says 12,000? 12 to 15,000 per half an hour. If we are able to monetize it, then definitely the broadcaster will be equally interested in drawing new audience, because that will be a total blue ocean strategy.
I've been in...
Hindi audiences are watching Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada films in Bombay because there's subtitling. And there's a
Absolutely.
Fund which has come up, which is going to start funding films in regional languages. Regional language is the fastest growing segment. And the audiences want to watch it because they love the content, because the creativity in regional is amazing.
Amazing. And there's a huge opportunity which is there. Like 197 movies which were released. If GEC can capitalize, and the kind of money that they are spending on the serials, kind of 1.50 lakh, if I'm right, for an half an hour episode, is an estimate for an half an hour episode. And plus, your 12,000 rupees is not going to make
12 to 15,000.
I'll add one more point over here, sir. When these Tamil movies or Malayalam, Telugu movies, all these movies have been done, what happens is that, you know, while going for a censorship, they have to give a complete script in English. So that will help them to put a subtitle over that. That's not the right way, but that helps them to get into subtitle thing and all. The other point that I'm adding up over here is that, you know, the management is a beast, which will always ask you a question, whether there is an increase in viewership when you put a subtitle. Is that because of the subtitle or because of the content and all? Without content, already I'm doing this much of business. What is the guarantee that you will get at the end of the day when you put a subtitle?
That's the question. I'm able to understand his pressure because he's just finished his month end and he's come in. Now, definitely, this question as a broadcaster, we will be looking at the cost-benefit ratio. But that will be a path-breaking idea that
even
we...
Even in the news segment, when there is a local development happening in Tamil Nadu, people like us from the west and the north, we want to know the local understanding of the development. The Hindi channels and the English channels do not understand it.
Absolutely.
So when you're so hyper-local, you'll understand it, you'll explain it, you'll give perspectives. But we don't get a chance to... We don't understand.
Even if I have a stringer there, appointed there, if there is a flood there in Kerala or in Mumbai, I prefer to watch their channel. I prefer to watch a Kairali or an Asianet to see that, to know that, and I take their feed. And similarly, what we can do is if we are able to subtitle, we are all... Some of the news channels, I don't want to name, you will have only scrolls and the L bands across and you will have only small images. But the point here is if we are able to get the subtitle for stickiness, why not? Because I'm only broadening my pond. That will be the entire thing which will help us out. It was a pleasure sitting with all of you, the distinguished panelists, on behalf of IndianTelevision.com and Tele-Wise, and I wish you all the very best, and it was a pleasure. And thank you, Anil, and thank you, IndianTelevision.com, for giving us this platform, Tele-Wise organizing team. We had a wonderful time. Wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, panelists, for the wonderful insight.